الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي بين الحق لخلقه وفصله تفصيلا. أحمده سبحانه وأشكره جل وعلا حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده بكرة وأصيلا. وأفضل الصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنام الذي ما فاقه أحد من العالمين لربه صبرا جميلا وشكرا جزيلا. اللهم صل وسلم وأنعم وبارك على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وإخوانه الذين اهتدوا بهديه واقتفوا أثره وساروا على نهجه وما بدلوا تبديلا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. اللهم أصلح لنا أعمالنا اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار والعياذ بالله. أوصيكم ونفسي أيها الإخوة الأحبة بتقوى الله عز وجل فإنه والله لا عز ولا نصر ولا توفيق ولا تسديد ولا نجاح ولا فلاح في هذه الدنيا والآخرة إلا بتقواه تبارك وتعالى والخشية منه ومراقبته جل وعلا في السر والعلانية. الله تبارك وتعالى بأسمائه الحسنى وصفاته العلى أن يجعلنا من المتقين، أن يجعلنا من المؤمنين المحسنين في هذه الدنيا والآخرة، إنه تبارك وتعالى خير مسؤول. All praise is due to Almighty Allah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. He is the one and only. He is the one and only God. He is the all-knowing, the all-seeing, the all-hearing, the all-wise, the one and only deity, subhanahu wa ta'ala, worthy of our sincere worship, worthy of our diligent service, worthy of our innermost love, worthy of our utmost appreciation, worthy of our highest and foremost devotion is the one and only God, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worthy of the best and most supreme names, Al-Asma al-Husna. And He is the one and only God, Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worthy of the best and most perfect attributes, الصفات العلى. ربنا وخالقنا ورازقنا رب العالمين. Our Lord, our Creator, our Cherisher, our Nourisher. Lord, my dear respected brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, today as we witness and as we celebrate and experience this special day, the day of Rahmah, the day of Barakah, a day of abundance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ma'idah Al-Yawma, أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. اليوم this is an ayah that was revealed in حجة الوداع, the farewell Hajj of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the 10th year of Al-Hijj. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in it reminds us and emphasizes that He has perfected our deen for us. أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَ. The deen is perfect. A perfect way of life. Perfect religion. Perfect rituals. Perfect way of thinking. Perfect lifestyle. أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَ. وأتممت عليكم نعمتي, and I have perfected my favor on you. وأتممت عليكم نعمتي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's favor has been perfected for us and upon us. ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully pleased with this deen to be ours, to be our way of life. And if we look at four surahs in the Quran, we will see this excellence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. We will see this excellence that leads to abundant life. And all of these surahs have been started with Inna, the royal we. We see excellence and we see abundance. The first one is Surah 48, Surah Al-Fatih. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna fatahna laka fatham mubeen. Inna fatahna laka fatham mubeen. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a great victory, a manifest victory. Inna fatahna laka fatham mubeen. What is this fatih? What is this victory? It is, as you know, the peace accord between the Prophet ﷺ and Quraysh, which took place in the 6th year of Al-Hijrah, year 6 of Al-Hijrah. Prophet ﷺ told the Sahaba radiallahu anhu to get ready and go to Umrah to visit Al-Kaaba, to visit Mecca. Close to Mecca, they were informed that they were not able, they are not going to be let or allowed into Mecca. And then the Prophet ﷺ tried to negotiate with the Qurayshiyyin, and this culminated, ended with this صلح الحديبيه. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it فتح, فتح مبين. Why? Because that peace accord allowed the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to focus on that. And it is at the end of the day, it is the opening of the hearts to embrace the truth, to embrace the Tawheed, to accept this way of life, to see the greatness in it, to see the excellence in it, to see the abundance in it, the opportunity to reach out to people, the opportunity to reach the hearts and minds. إنا فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا. In it, in the same surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لقد رضي الله عن المؤمنين إذ يبايعونك تحت الشجرة فعلم ما في قلوبهم فأنزل السكينة عليهم وأثابهم فتحا قريبا. In this ayah 18, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of what happened during this incident. Is that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum pledged their support, their allegiance to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was so pleased with them. He knew what was in their hearts. He knew their dedication, their sincerity, their total devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. علم ما في قلوبهم. He knew the excellence of their iman, the strength of their loyalty to Allah سبحانه وتعالى من المسجد صلى الله عليه وسلم. فعلم ما في قلوبهم. فأنزل السكينة عليهم. And he put down peace and tranquility. وأثابهم فتحا. And he gave them so much, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He opened the world for them. It was their hearts. It was their iman. It was their sincerity. The excellence of iman. The second surah is Surah Nuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is surah 71. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ أَنذِرْ قَوْمَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ عَذَابٌ. Indeed, we sent Nuh alayhi salam to warn his people. To warn his people. And Nuh alayhi salam said in the surah, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا. He said, oh Allah, oh my Lord, I have invited, called my people in the night and in the day. This was continuous death on the part of this great messenger of Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ankabut, فَلَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. 950 years of death. 950 years of continuous time. And this is the excellence in death. The excellence in Iman in Surah Al-Fatih. This is the excellence in da'wah that we need. We need to understand. And we need to apply. Continuous dedication to the cause of da'wah. قال إني دعوت قومي ليلا ونهارا فلم يزدهم دعائي إلا فرارا وإني كلما دعوتهم لتغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم. They will put, every time he tries to call them, they will put their fingers in their ears. They will do childish things. Just for them not to listen to what he says. يرسل السماء عليهم مدرارا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us what he used to say to his people, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with your accepting this da'wah, you will have so much abundance. You will gain so much by embracing the people, by accepting this way of life. A أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما ينبغي لجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه، حمدا كما يحمده الاولون والاخرون، وكما يحمده الانبياء والمرسلون والصديقون والشهداء والصالحون. اللهم ربنا لك الحمد عدد خلقك ورضا نفسك وزينه عرشك ومداد كلماتك. اللهم ربنا لك الحمد بما انت اهله كما انت اهله رب العالمين. اللهم ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال ذاتك وعظيم صفاتك وجميل آلائك. اللهم صل وسلم وأنعم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد أذن الخير التي استمعت إلى آخر إرسال السماء لهذه الأرض، ورسول الصدق الذي بلغ عن الحق تعالى مراده للخلق. اللهم صل وسلم وأنعم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه واقتفى أثره واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we saw this excellent way of life. And we saw how the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم had their excellence in faith, in Iman. And we saw in Surah Nuh how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of our duty. Our duty to call others to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that this is a continuous mission, continuous duty that we have to think about every day. We have to be concerned about. We have to be concerned about the people. We have to be concerned about our neighbors, about our colleagues, about our friends. We have to be concerned about humanity. We have to be concerned about the people, that they will reach, they will embrace, they will have an opportunity to understand this deen. The third surah that begins with Inna is Surah Al-Qadr, Surah 97. And in it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us and gives us an opportunity to excel in ibadah. And the abundance of reward upon doing that. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. Wa ma adraka ma laylatil qadr. Please come forward with your brothers for me. Please come forward, جزاكم الله خيرا. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. This is a special night we all know. You could worship for a few hours and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the reward of almost 100 years of Iman. ألف شهر. Almost 100 years. It could be more than 100 years. خير من ألف شهر. And this surah, my brothers and sisters, should always be in our hearts and minds. That it is the engine for us when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we pray. For the salah, let's remember the rewards of this night and how few hours of ibadah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give us so much of blessings. خير من الجنة. The excellence in ibadah. And this is not only Ramadan, as you know, or in the first 10 days of the Hijjah, or in a few days here and there in the year. This is supposed to be our motivation each and every day. Every time we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to remember How generous Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. How great His ajr can be subhanahu wa ta'ala. How our need to focus, to benefit, to dedicate ourselves in these few moments in our salah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not let it be spoiled by our thinking about all affairs and concerns and things that we busy ourselves in this world. Excellence of Iman. So in Surah Al-Fatih, we saw excellence in Iman. In Surah Nuh, we saw excellence in Da'wah. In Surah Al-Qadr, we see excellence in Ibadah. Remember Surah Al-Qadr, remember the rewards. Remember when you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, the fourth surah, Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. Indeed, we have given O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-khayr al-kathir, goodness of every soul. Everything. This is what is in the heart of the believer. This is what is in the mind of a true Muslim. A mu'min. Always think in abundance terms. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has so much. And by us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the next ayah, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَنْحَرْ. Exercising that abundance in our ibadah, in both of its aspects. Glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and caring for the makhluk, caring for humanity. Both sides of ibadah. Both are ibadat. When we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's ibadah. And when we are generous and kind and caring and serving others, that is also ibadah. And that is the excellence of service. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَنْحَرْ. And this day symbolizes that. The day when we give the Qurban this audio for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we keep part of it to give as gifts to our neighbors, to our friends, to our loved ones. And we can give part of it also to those who are in the day of service. A day when we think of others. A day when we witness the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in turn, extend that. And we show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are truly grateful for what He has given us. Four areas of excellence. In Iman reads Surah Al-Fatih. In Da'wah reads Surah Al-Fatih. In Ibadah read Surah Inna Anzalnahu Fi Laylatil Qadr. And in service, definitely always think about Surah Al-Kawthar. Allahumma irhamna min hadha al-ijtima' al-mahzum. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل على محمد